was 12 years old, my parents went on a trip to Texas and left me at my aunt's. They were expected to be gone for 3 weeks, and I had to deal with the boring house my aunt lived in. She had no video games, no DVDs, and no TV. What did they expect me to do for 3 weeks while they were out living it up in Texas? I remember how long those weeks dragged out. Every day seemed to last years as I waited for the 3 weeks to pass. Then, on the third week, my aunt told me that my parents wouldn't be coming back for another 3 weeks. She seemed upset when she said this, and I figured it was because she was stuck watching me for an extra 3 weeks. The next 3 weeks weren't that bad. I had met a friend down the street from my aunt's house, and he had a PS2 that we would play all day. I was starting to enjoy myself. At the end of the next 3 weeks, I was more than ready to see my parents. A month and a half without them was terrible, and I missed my home. My aunt walked outside as I headed out with my bags packed. I remember how upset I was when she told me that my parents had decided to go to New Mexico for 3 more weeks. I thought they had abandoned me, and I started to get depressed. The next 3 weeks were just as uneventful as the first 3. I had forgotten how my house looked, and I had nearly forgotten the faces of my parents. I was ready to go home. The night before my parents were supposed to be back, I was woken up to a tap on my shoulder. I looked up and saw my mother and father standing over the bed smiling at me. I was so happy to see them, and I hopped out of my bed to hug them both. "We can't stay for long, buddy. We have somewhere else we need to go," I remember my dad saying. We walked out to the car and they drove me around for a while. We didn't talk much, but I was so happy to be with them even for a little while. When we finally arrived back at my aunt's house, I was reluctant to let them leave. I ran into my room and came back with the camera my dad had bought me before they left. I asked them to take a picture with me so I wouldn't forget their faces. I set the camera on the hood of the car and set the timer on it before hugging my parents and waiting for the flash. After that, my dad wrote something on the back of the picture and handed it to me before he and my mother got in the car and drove off. In the morning, I woke my aunt up and told her that my mother and father had visited me last night. She looked at me with so much sadness in her face that it worried me.
You must have been dreaming," she said to me, fighting back the tears.
"Why?" I asked her. She hesitated a moment before she answered me. Tears were now rolling down her cheeks.
Your parents died in a car crash on the way to Texas."
I laughed when she said this. There was no way it was a dream. Then I remembered the picture I had taken with my parents, and I ran into my room to get it. I grabbed it without even looking at it and ran into my aunt's room to show it to her. "Look, this is the proof they were here." I handed it to her. When she looked at the picture, she screamed and dropped it. Her face turned as white as snow, and she covered her mouth. I was confused, so I picked up the picture and looked at it. The picture showed me standing out in front of my aunt's house, hugging the mutilated figures of my parents. I couldn't believe what I was looking at. I dropped the picture on the floor as my hands went numb. The picture landed upside down, and I read the words written on the back. "We're sorry, kiddo.